All right, in this video we're going to cover string insertion, so how you can actually put things inside of strings. It's not quite concatenation, it's actually something completely different. So we are covering 7.2 and 7.3 from the textbook material. All right, so when I talk about insertion, I'm not talking about concatenation. Concatenation, you take one string and you add another string's characters to the end of it. So string one and string two, like we've seen before, you take string one and you cram string two's characters to the end of string one. You end up with a new string that has all of string one's characters and then all of string two's characters. And that's what we've been working with this whole time. But insertion is a little bit different because you are adding characters anywhere inside of a string. You are essentially creating a new substring inside of a string. You're like cramming it in there. So it could be at the beginning, it could be at the end. Both of those are possible with concatenation, but it could also be somewhere in the middle. Now note that we're not changing the original string when we do insertion like this. We are creating a new string. So if we are inserting string 2 in the middle of string 1 and string 2 don't change, we make some string 3 that has all string 1's characters, but all of string 2's characters are somewhere in the middle, in between the first half of string 1's and the second half of string 1's, or something like that. So the method we are talking about here is the .insert method of a string, where you put in the starting index of where you want the new string that you're inserting to go, and then the string itself. Now, the starting index is essentially where the first character of string value is going to be in this new string. And I'll show off some examples of this, but yeah, we're putting string value inside of string name, and string value in this new string. String value is a substring starting at the index int start. Now what I have here is a whole bunch of examples of putting blah inside of the string containing Santa Maria. Now if I insert it so that it starts at index 0, then at index 0 you have uppercase B, index 1 you have lowercase l, index 2 is lowercase a, index 3 is lowercase h, index 4 is uppercase s, index 5 is lowercase a, index 6 is lowercase n, and so on and so on. So I'm sticking blah in front of Santa Maria, and blah starts at index 0. If I start it at index 3 instead, then it will start right where this T is supposed to go. What happens there is that blah kind of muscles its way and it says, I want to start at index 3 now, all of you have to wait after me. So we have san, blah, and then, let's see, B-L-A-H, at index 7, the letter T, index 8, the letter A, index 9 is a space, and so on and so forth. So blah starts at index 3. If we start it at index 10, which is the last valid index for Santa Maria, it actually muscles this A out of the way. So the A then comes after blah. We have Santa Marie blah ah. If we want to actually put blah at the very end, we want to concatenate it to the end, what we can actually do is put in 11, or the length of our string city right here. And that actually sticks blah at the end. So you're, in this case, you're actually allowed to use the length of the string as your index, as your starting index, because we're adding more things in. When we do this, we are actually putting something into index 11, which means that it's fine to do. But we couldn't do index 12 because there would be nothing in index 11 still. And that wouldn't be great. And Visual Basic doesn't want to assume that we want to put like a space or something in there. It doesn't want to assume that So then it would say, okay, well, there would just be nothing in 11, which means we would have 10 is A, 11 is nothing, 12 is B. That's not good. And it would give us an error. But we can start it at 11, unlike the other methods that we've seen before. So we get an argument out of range exception for the insert method when our starting index int n, in this case, is less than 0. Or when int n is greater than string name.length. But like I said before, it's okay if int n is equal to string name.length. Alright, so the next set of methods that we have are padLeft and padRight. PadLeft, we'll focus on PadLeft at first, but it's a really useful method for making strings that are right aligned. So if you have a string that you know you want to be exactly 10 characters, and you want everything in the string to be right aligned, rather than having to calculate the length of everything else and then stick a whole bunch of spaces in front of it until you get to 10, you can just use padLeft. So what happens is padLeft is going to make a new string that has a length of int num. If you put in 10, the resulting string will be 10. Whatever character is specified is going to get added to the left until that string is 10 long, until it has a length of 10. So if I'm trying to put blah, put a whole bunch of spaces in front of blah until it is 10 long, then you're going to get a string containing 6 spaces and then the word blah. So it stops adding characters to the left when the length is equal to int num. Now, if you don't specify the padding character, padchar here, then it will add spaces to the left. But you can optionally specify a different character, say the asterisk character, or the dollar sign character, or the pound sign character, or whatever, and it will just add that character to the left instead. But you have to make sure that you're specifying a character using the C, and not a string. Now, we also have padWrite, which is the same as padLeft, but it adds to the right. It will just, if you wanted to make it 10 long but keep it left justified and just have a long tail of characters, then you would use padRight. So for example, if I have the string containing blah, and I padLeft and pass in 7, I'm going to end up with 3 spaces and then the word blah. It's only 3 spaces, but the entire length of this string is 7. 3 plus 4 for the word blah is 7 there. Now if I take blah and I pad right to a length of 9 with asterisks, then I end up with the word blah and then 5 asterisks afterwards for a total length of 9 characters. Now if the length is less than the length of the string already, then nothing bad happens. It just returns the original string. You don't get an error or anything like that. It's just the original string. So if the length is greater than or equal to the number that you pass in, then pad left and pad right just don't do anything. Otherwise, they add characters to the end until the length is greater than or equal to. Actually, they probably just do some manual calculations without having to worry about a loop, but regardless, that's the idea. Now, what I have is this application where I just type in a net pay amount, and then it formats it and displays it to me really nicely. So I can type in 123.45, and it will format everything. 123.45, there's a dollar sign at the very beginning, and 4 asterisks there. However, if I do 6, 7, 8, 9, all that kind of stuff, right? It still doesn't actually change the number of asterisks, because what happens here is it tries to parse my input, which succeeds, and then it formats the first value that I put in and rounds it to 2. using this N2 value, not C2, because we don't want the dollar sign at the beginning, N2 here. So then it formats it with N2, that's where you get the nice number formatting. And then it pads with asterisks until it reaches 10 characters, which you see right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the dollar amount, and then 4 asterisks above, and then it inserts a dollar sign at the very beginning. But with all that padding, right, that's why it's important to round it before. Well, you have to round it anyway because you're converting from the decimal to the string, but that's why it's important to round it, because otherwise all these extra digits that don't even mean anything for currency would sneak in there and hog all the asterisks, and we don't want that. Now, let's see. I'll type in 100 as well, and it's exactly the same thing because N2 forces 2 decimal points. Now let me add in one more digit, and you might expect there to be one fewer asterisk because I added one more digit, but that wouldn't necessarily be correct. You'd actually lose 2 asterisks. Because this is N2 formatting, we have the extra 0 that I put up here, of course, but then we also have the comma, which counts as another character in the string, which then affects pad left, because pad left is checking the entire length of the string, not the number of numbers in the string. That's a really important distinction to make here. But that's just a quick use of pad left. All right, well, that is string insertion. This actually gives us a bunch of really helpful tools that we don't have with just concatenation in order to make things easier for ourselves. Like, yeah, sure, we could do string insertion by, we could do string insertion by doing some weird stuff with substring and concatenation and all that, but we could just use the dot insert method. We could do pad left and pad right using loops and creating a padding string, but we don't have to worry about that. We have these very helpful methods for us.